Are luxury sneakers worth the money? Today we're specifically talking about the Stardan shoe by Golden Goose. These retail for about $700 to $800, which is a huge amount of money for a pair of shoes. Today I'm gonna talk about the sizing, the quality, the versatility, the overall build on the shoe, and the magic question, is it worth spending that much money on a shoe? Let's get into the video and find out. So first and foremost is the sizing. Now these shoes do fit true to size. I have a 44 here, which is my standard fit. The nice thing with this shoe in particular is it has a wider footbed in comparison to the Ball Star or All Star, which are also very popular shoes by Golden Goose. So for me, having wide, flat feet, this is a really nice fit. It fits me like a glove and they're very, very comfortable. And like I said, true to size. If you're enjoying the video so far, please take 2 seconds to drop a like and subscribe. It would mean the world to me and make a difference to the channel, and I appreciate you. Now let's talk about the comfort of the shoe. Like I said, it is a wider footbed. So if you have wide feet, very comfortable, great fit. They do fit me very well. The only downside I would say that these shoes have is these are designed to not be laced up, right? They're kind of tied on the end here. That's the look for Golden Goose, is to have them just look very natural and like you've worn them 1,000 times. That allows for great comfort. It's literally like wearing a slipper. It's super nice. It's easy to get on and off. Where this comes to a downside is if you're gonna be walking all day long, like if you're going to Disneyland or something like that, every time you step, this gets pulled a little bit. So these get shorter and shorter, and this kind of gets looser and looser. So I have found that wearing these for long periods of time, I do have to kind of bend down and give them a quick tug to tighten them up again. Is it the end of the world? Absolutely not, but something to think about. So 10 out of 10 when it comes to comfort. Next, let's talk versatility. If you're spending this much money on a shoe, you want to wear it as much as possible. The really nice thing with this specific colorway and style is it's pretty understated. If you don't know Golden Goose, if you don't recognize that star, or you know, the Stardan or this, you're not gonna know what the shoe is. It doesn't look loud. It's not something that stands out like crazy. I don't wanna get into comparing other brands, but just to sum it up quickly, it's not an overly stated shoe. Some shoes are very loud. You can only wear them once in a while. And everybody's gonna know, oh, he's wearing that shoe or she's wearing that, and it's very obvious and you can't wear it as much. These kind of fly under the radar a lot more. Kind of if you know type thing, which I kind of like. But if you know much about Golden Goose, you know it's all about the distressing. Now, the nice thing with this shoe, it's not overly distressed at all. This part is, which is awesome, because that's the part that's gonna get the dirtiest. So this has come with some discoloring and some distressing from the factory, but the rest of the shoe is not overly distressed. It's nice and clean, but it's nothing that's overly done. It's easy to wear. You can dress it up, you can dress it down. I just recently wore these in Hawaii with high socks, shorts, and a t-shirt. I've also worn them out to fancy dinners with jeans and a nice sport coat. So they're very versatile. I like the blue touch on here because it works well with jeans, but it's also a pop if you're just wearing a basic outfit. And a really nice touch is the gray laces. When I was in store buying the shoes, I wanted white laces, but now that I've worn the gray, I realize how much gray I wear. I'm wearing it right now. And with an outfit like this, it just ties in really nicely. It kind of adds a pop to the shoe, pop to the fit, and it also ties in with the suede star, which is just another nice touch. So overall versatility, I would say, is very good. Again, you can dress them up, you can dress them down, you can wear them pretty much anywhere, and they're gonna look good, and they kind of fly under the radar, which I really like about the shoe. Now let's talk about the quality and the build. So they are all handmade in Italy. Whole bottom here is rubber, which I actually like more than I thought. Typically on a high quality shoe, it's all leather, but I've really come to love the fact that these are rubber. Whole top here is cow's leather along with the tongue, and then obviously some suede touches and cotton touches on the inside of the tongue. Now, one thing to keep in mind with these being cow leather is it is pretty soft, so you don't want this toe bed to get creased. That's why whenever I'm not wearing them, I do have a shoe tree in there just to help keep the shoe's shape. But again, very happy with the quality. You can tell it's well made, you can tell it's well built, and I haven't noticed any issues at all thus far. Now the magic question, are luxury shoes and is this shoe worth the money? Obviously this is very subjective, so I'm keeping finances out of this. I'm assuming you can afford the shoe if you wanted to. This is my first pair of really expensive shoes. I've spent a couple $100, but you know, this is pushing the limits, closer to $1,000, which is a lot of money to be spending on a shoe. My thoughts are, I'm very happy with them. You know, shoes are that one part of your outfit that can make or break the whole fit. And like I said earlier, the fact that these kind of fly under the radar, it kind of makes the shoe a little bit more special. And it's so versatile and simple, yet elegant at the same time, that I've really fallen in love with them. And to be honest, I think my favorite thing is that not everybody needs to know that this is a very expensive shoe. And I think what's cool about that is you know what it is. You know that you spent some money on some very nice shoes and worked hard for it. I think the fact that I can just wear, you know, shorts and a t-shirt and these and just know that, you know, I'm feeling stylish, I'm feeling good. You don't need to overcomplicate a whole fit. If you start incorporating just some really nice pieces that you love and that are built well, made well, and that suit your style very well, you don't need to try as hard with the rest of the outfit. And I think shoes are one of those things that, you know, you can spend more money on and you're gonna see the value there. So yes, I do think they're worth it. I really hope this helped you guys out, whether you're looking to make your first luxury shoe purchase or even purchase this pair specifically. If you have any questions, please drop them below. I'm happy to get back to you guys and help you out. If you haven't yet, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.